During a song's playback, triggered notes can be cut short by the note off command. When recording live, this is automatically entered into the pattern editor as the note is released. Otherwise, it is recorded manually with caps lock or the A key. How this affects the plugin and MIDI components of an instrument will depend on the specific settings that they are using. For samples though, a note off command can trigger any or all of these three things. Any samples with loops will immediately stop looping. But that's as long as this option is disabled. When turned on, this sample can continue finishing its current loop in a few different ways, depending on the loop type. A forward loop will continue to the end of the sample. If the loop endpoint is before the end of the sample, it is completely ignored, which can be a useful way to set up simple loop and release instruments. The backwards loop will finish if it's already in the backwards phase. If it's not, then the note off will trigger the reversal from the sample's current playback position. If the loop start point is after the start of the sample, it will be ignored. Ping pong will behave like a forward loop if cut during the forward phase. If cut during the backwards phase, the playback will continue to the start of the loop, then start forwards again, playing to the end of the sample. In the sampler's modulation section, any AHDSR or envelope devices used in this instrument will immediately advance to their release phase. For AHDSR, this is very straightforward. However, the envelope device requires some explanation. First, the release parameter is only present when the device is used in the volume domain. And secondly, the loop feature will loop the envelope normally if there is no sustain point. But if the sustain point is active, then playback of the envelope will stop there until the note off, and then it will move into the loop. If you're new to creating modulations and you're wondering why inserting AHDSR or envelope devices just cuts to silence upon a note off, remember that by default, waveform playback will just stop. You need to override this with the release phase of an AHDSR or envelope device in the volume domain. And or extending a sample loop by enabling this button, as shown in the previous section. Instruments can also have an entirely different set of samples that are triggered by a note-off event, though this only happens as long as at least one of the note-on samples is still playing. A sample can be moved to the note-off layer by right-clicking on it and selecting that option from the menu, and they can be moved back in the same way. This might seem like the simplest of the three things that a note-off can trigger, and in its basic form, shown here, it is. However, it has some restrictions that you need to deal with, and getting the most out of it requires creatively incorporating some more advanced features. That obviously goes beyond the scope of this more basic tutorial, but if you're interested, then check out the sampler note-off layer video. It provides full details and also work through a few examples to hopefully inspire you to create your own techniques. New notes in the same column will trigger the NNA, new note action, for each sample. The default setting is note off. So, for a note that's playing, a new note acts like a note off command. Setting the NNA to cut will also stop the sample's playback, but won't trigger any of the note-off actions shown in this video, instantly silencing it. To use an instrument polyphonically, you normally just use multiple note columns, but by setting the NNA to continue, you can create the sustained playback of multiple notes using a single note column. Now, you've probably already guessed this, but something to be aware of in this situation is that a note-off command will trigger the note-off actions for all of the notes that are still playing, all at once.